later.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to The Loud Spot. I'm your host, Sebastian Cosby, right out of Oklahoma City, hanging out with the very lovely weird wolf, Ava Gore. Hello, Ava.
Hello.
Although I said hello to you before we started this.
Yes.
So we were supposed to have a band on tonight called El Dusty. They winded up actually booking a show, concert tonight on Cinco de Mayo. So we wound up not being able to play them. But I called Ava and we were texting and we decided let's do the show. So I got my Mexican beer. I got my Modelo Chelada. I don't think I'm gonna like it though. and I suck at doing shots. Oh yeah, you got whiskey. We can lie and say it's tequila.
It's apple juice.
It's apple juice. And then I got a 1800. I suck at doing shots, but I do have a shot glass with limes and lemon. All right. So I'm gonna pour one right now, actually. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna do some Cinco de Mayo trivia, and then even though El Dusty couldn't be here today, we are happy that they are back to doing concerts. So cheers to them for being able to do that. And we were able to pull one of their songs. And we're going to go ahead and do a live reaction to that after we do our trivia game. So here's the deal. I don't know the answers, okay? So I know the questions. I did not cheat. Look at the answers. Okay, so I don't know if we're going to do all 20 of them. But we might do 20.
Okay.
We'll see how it goes.
It's going to be a train wreck.
I think so. This whole episode's going to be a train wreck. That's okay. Okay. First question, Ava, and I'm the only one asking the question. Sam said lies. Okay. In what country is Cinco de Mayo most widely celebrated? This should be easy, right? Mexico.
It's the U.S.
You think it's the U.S.?
Yes.
I'm going to go with Mexico on this one. I'm going to go scroll down and look at the answer. Oh, Sam said lies. I said I don't know the answer.
Okay.
Is it the U.S.? Now, and by the way, this trivia game, I just pulled it offline. So I don't know if the answers are accurate or not accurate.
Okay. You
know? So I don't know So the answer for this one is B. Cinco de Mayo is largely only celebrated in Pueblo, Mexico.
What?
Not across the country. According to this Cinco de Mayo trivia, you are incorrect. That is a drink for you.
Okay. Well, I thought.
And you could be right. You could be right.
That like it's more like celebrated, like people have gatherings, celebrate. I don't know. And like in Mexico, it's more just like a day to remember.
Okay, so it says in what country is now? It's good. Never mind. I'm an idiot. Yeah, no. I mean, it still says Mexico. It says, but the actual answer is Cinco de Mayo is largely only celebrated in Pueblo, Mexico.
That sounds wrong. Only celebrated.
Well, I think it's only. I think it's talking about in Mexico, like inside of Mexico.
Okay, gotcha.
Right, like not the whole. Like it's mostly celebrated within that country. But the question did say, in what country is Cinco de Mayo mostly celebrated? So anyway, okay. Did you take your drink?
Yes.
Because I wasn't looking. All right. I'll rewatch the video and I'll find out. Okay. Next question. What other holiday is Cinco de Mayo most frequently confused with? Mardi Gras, Day of the Dead, 4th of July, Mexican Independence Day.
Mexican Independence Day.
Is it not Mexican Independence Day? I guess not. I was going to say Day of the Dead, but I'm going to actually, I think you're probably right. Yep, D, Mexican Independence Day is celebrated on September 16th. All right. Tequila or Modelo?
Tequila.
You would. Let me get my lime. Sharon said no thought patterns tonight. No, we're just winging this. We're just going to wing this episode.
Okay, sorry, guys.
Sorry. We had other plans, but those plans failed. Now we're just doing our own thing. I'd have an extra lime in it. Oh, God.
I hate tequila.
Oh, my God. That was horrible. Oh, my God. That's my take. I just took a shot face. And that was like only like a half shot. That wasn't even a full shot. Okay. Next question. Oops. Oh, I closed. Okay. On May 5th, 1862, a Mexican militia unexpectedly defeated the French in what battle? The Battle of Puebla, Battle of the Alamo, Battle of Palo Alto, or Battle of Buena Vista?
The Battle of Puebla.
I would say the Battle of Puebla. What'd you say?
Puebla.
I would say the Battle of Puebla only because it says it's mostly celebrated in Puebla, Mexico, right? Yes,
so we both agree.
Yeah, I agree with that. Yep, the Battle of Puebla. Okay, no drinks. No drinks. This is kind of fun. Okay, let's see here. What French leader sent troops to Mexico in an effort to assert territorial control?
Fuck.
King Louis or King Louis the 18th? King Charles the 10th? Duke of, I don't know how to say that, Reichstag? Emperor Napoleon the 3rd? I have no idea.
Napoleon the 3rd.
Okay. I'm going to go with that one because that's the only one that sounds real familiar to me. I'm going to go with D also. What was that? Yep, Napoleon the 3rd. That was a good guess. I just went with whatever you said. Okay, all right, here we go. Let's see here. During what decades did Cinco de Mayo celebrations become popular in the U.S.? 1920 to 30, 50 to 60, 80 to 90, or 2000 to 2010? Ooh, I'm gonna go with 50 to 60 or 80 to 90.
I'm gonna go with 80 to 90. I think.
Tiffany, I just wanted to see you do a live shot on camera. Yeah, thanks. Hey, horrible. What are you gonna go with?
80 to 90, I guess.
Okay, that's what I'm gonna go with 50 to 60 just to disagree with you.
Okay.
Just to disagree. Cinco de Mayo begins the U.S. Well, that's not the answer. B. The answer is B. What was B?
50 to 60, I think.
I got it right.
Ah.
All right, now you got to do a shot. Or a drink. I know you won't do a shot.
Yeah, I just do sips.
Oh, we're going to do two more, then we're going to play the song.
Okay.
How many men made up the Mexican militia that defeated the French in the battle on May 5th, 1862?
2,000.
Oh, you knew the answer. You looked that up. I told you we were going to do Mexican or Cinco de Mayo trivia. And knowing you, you went and wanted to be prepared. And you looked up the question.
No, what happened was I looked it up. And then you texted me like as I was looking it up. So I saw a couple things. You texted me about the trivia game. So you said you didn't know the answers. So like I saw a couple things and then like I stopped looking because I felt bad if I knew all.
Yeah, you prepared. I didn't prepare.
That one was one of those ones.
I'm gonna go with 2,000 as well. That's letter C. Look how smart we are. Cheater. Yeah, 2,000's right. Okay. All right, let's see here. Well, I'm not yet there. Okay. Who was the president of Mexico in 1862? Vicente Fox. I don't know how to say that. Luis Alvarez. I don't know how to say the middle name. Pedro Lasarin or Benito Juarez. 1862.
The last one, because you said it all dramatic.
But I knew how to say it. So I said Benito Juarez.
I know, but I was like, Juarez. You know,
okay, I'll go with I'll go with the one I don't know how to read, B. So you go with D, I'll go with B. You're right, Benito Juarez.
Okay, I'm just going to pick whichever one you say the most dramatic then.
All right, we'll do one more, then we'll play the song. We'll do one more, then we'll play the song.
Okay.
Okay. What is the most popular food eaten on Cinco de Mayo in Mexico? Is it tacos, taquitos, tamales, or mole poblano?
Yeah, I'm gonna go with the last one because you said that the most red.
I'm gonna go with tamales. I'm gonna go with, because you see all those tamale trucks, right? Oh, the little tamale carts. So I'm gonna go with tamales. All right, that was number eight. Number eight is it's mole poblano.
Yes.
I even tried to get that one. That's not even you
just,
fair.
You just like naturally say each one. The right answer, more dramatic.
Yeah, that was okay. The last one now. The last one. Then we'll do the song. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to do a dramatic one. Where does the largest Cinco de Mayo celebration take place? Well, you said Puebla, Mexico. So we're not going to ask that one.
Okay.
We're not going to do that. So some of these questions actually kind of repeat. Like they repeat themselves. Okay. Let me see here. How many pounds of avocados do Americans consume on Cinco de Mayo? How many pounds of avocados? 80,000, 800,000, 81 million, or 8 billion?
I'm going to have to go see because it says the most.
81 million. Okay, let me see. Number 16. I swear to God, it is C.
What?
Yeah.
There's no way.
The California Avocado Commission estimates 81 million pounds are eaten.
What?
I swear to God, I do not know these answers at all.
That is nuts.
At all.
81 million. Like, I also picked that one because I was like, there's no way that's right.
Yeah, and I said it all dramatically because I didn't think it was going to be right. I thought it was like 800,000, like seemed like a lot, but I guess fair. Okay, let's play this song. The song is called Cumbia Anthem featuring Happy Colors by the band El Dusty, who could not be here tonight, but awesome that they're getting to play concerts. All right, here we go. Ava, I didn't mean to do that. Hold on. Do you know what Day of the Dead is?
Like very vaguely, you know.
Okay, it's like those skulls. So it's celebrated in Mexico, right?
Right, 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 right.
Okay, to celebrate the Day of the Dead,
dead loved ones and stuff. Yeah.
Uh-huh. So I think it's Los Días de los Muertos or something like that. So whenever I see skulls and like with Mexican music, I immediately think of, like, when I think of skulls outside of that, I think of like punk rock or metal. But when it comes to in Mexican culture, I think of Day of the Dead. And those are kind of the skulls that he's wearing on the shirt and kind of themed throughout the video. So here we go. So we're not going to know what he says. Are you dancing? Are you just dancing over there? Sorry. So we're not going to know what he's saying to that song because I don't speak Spanish. I should, but I don't. And I definitely know you probably don't.
I do not.
But the band is, from what I think, it's Corpus Christi. All right. So here we go. Me parece que te vi bailando un día. Me parece que te vi.